Mishima himself had samurai ancestry, and he was extremely proud of it.
You can easily find two contradictional characteristics of Japanese cultures or Japanese characters. One is elegance, one is brutality. But these two characteristics are very tightly combined sometimes, and our brutality, I think, comes from our emotion. It is never mechanized or systematized like Nazi's brutality. And I think the brutality might come from our feminine aspect, and elegance comes from our nervous side. Sometimes we are too sensitive about refinement or elegance or sense of beauty of such aesthetic side. And sometimes we are tired of it. And we need sometimes a sudden explosion to make us free from it. And for instance, after the war, our brutal side was completely hidden. But I believe it is just hidden, I think. And I don't like the Japanese culture is represented only by the flower arrangement, such a sort of peace-loving culture. We still have a very strong warrior's mind in our... I particularly like Kendo from the sense of beauty, but gradually I found out the traditional value of the Kendo, and it used to be close to the duel, death fighting, and old Kendo player wanted to get real experience of the border of death and life, you know. And in the samurai tradition, the sense of beauty was always connected with death. And for instance, if you commit harakiri, the samurai was requested to make up his face by powder or lipsticks in order to keep his face beautiful after his such a suffering death. Economical prosperity gives some bored feeling already, and it gave a big, huge spiritual vacuum and unbearable boredom, particularly among intellectuals. But I think not only intellectuals, but also among younger generations and half of populace, I think. And at the present situation, we are never satisfied, we are never contented. And we cannot believe such an economic prosperity. What it means? And we had, you know, long tradition of samurai. They lived for the honor and the spirit, you know, and they despised and looked down any money.
Inspired by the No Theatre, Mishima wrote his own No plays. This is one of them. But he transferred the action from the 12th century to a modern setting.
I found out it is quite impossible to transfer the old stylized beauty of the No play. And I cut it off. I just picked up only the theme. For instance, in My Lady Aoi, the original No play takes place in some court life in the 12th century, and I moved it into the modern hospital in the 20th century.
Mishima's interest in the theatre began with the popular form, kabuki. As a child, he'd often been taken to kabuki by his grandmother. Now he began to work with kabuki actors, writing his own adaptations for their theatre.
Kabuki was developed among populace. And it was considered quite a baroque, quite a bizarre place. And samurai was not permitted to go to kabuki theater because it was considered quite a vulgar place. But in such a way, Kabuki developed itself in a remarkable way. It has a lot of baroque characteristics, mixing up of tragic side and the humorous side. At the beginning, Kabuki was acted by a woman. It's called a famous woman dancer called Izumo Okuni. But the Tokugawa government was very Confucianistic, you know, and they prohibited the women on the theater because the actress was suspected as a sort of prostitute. And then Kabuki used the boys as a woman's part. But boys are also used as for the male prostitution. And the Tokugawa government prohibited it again. And then the Kabuki actors had to find their own way to act a female part, even by adult actors, which made an improvement in the technical acting of a female role. And it started around the 18th century, and through the 200 years, they developed a marvelous technique to express female part by man actors.
I particularly picked up the student from the university where the conflict or trouble happened. And such a minority of students who cannot be involved into the leftist movement felt very isolated and very separated. And so they believed In some sense, they believed their own Japan and Japanese spirit, but you know, it was completely denied by the leftist student movement. Spiritually, I wanted to revive some samurai spirit through it, because I don't want to revive Harakiri itself, but through the vision of such a very strong vision of Harakiri, I wanted to inspire and stimulate younger people. And through such a stimulation, I wanted to revive some old traditional sense of honor, or sense of very strong responsibility, and such a sense of death in honor. That's my purpose.
Such a way of very extreme eroticism and such a bloody eroticism is, maybe it was born in my mind from my birth. It's, and on the other hand, I don't want to show it as a private confession or something like that. I want to combine it with the most public situation. The Harakiri is a very positive, very proud way of death. I think it is very different from the Western concept of suicide. Western concept of suicide is always defeat itself, mostly. But Harakiri sometimes makes you win.